concrete work. I build the forms. Still don't really have that many women on the rig. I love to watch the documentary on this and the Golden Gate. I watch them over and over and over, yeah. I wish that I could work then, really, instead of now, because then you could just, you could climb up here without your lanyard, you know. You didn't have to tie off. You could pretty much monkey swing across the modern bridge if you wanted. But now, you have to have all this hardware on and clip off, and it just doesn't feel as free. Well, you could have just threw a beam to your partner, you know. Every bridge, you think about the people that are driving across it, and you better do things right, you know. And you think it's different than, you know, if you're building a deck in your backyard or something. Okay, come up on that one a little bit. Up on. I joined the Army about 2 days after I graduated high school. And I think I did that because I was too shy to look for a job. And then the Army kind of broke the shyness some for me, so.
Was it because of the culture of the Army that sort of you're supposed to be really tough and...
No, it was the Anheuser-Busch. After basic training, we went to AIT, and it was just an electrical school, you know, and it was Signal Corps. As soon as you were done with your class, they all drank. I don't know anyone that did anything else. And at least as far as I saw. But I didn't return to base a few times and several times. They wanted to give me some alcohol treatment. They wanted me to go into an institutionalized program there. I didn't want to. I just rather got out. And then I went, I wanted to be a welder.
Once the traveler rails are removed, the span will be ready to make the final touchdown.
It's a little hectic with the tide and the wind.
The currents get up to like 6 knots sometimes, which is a pretty good clip.
So I went to take a welding class, and the welding class was full. So they told me to take a related trade.
Down about 2 feet.
And they put me in carpentry, and they were going to have me in there till welding opened up. And the carpentry teacher asked me to stay and complete the carpentry class. So I did, instead of going into welding. And then he told me when I graduated from that class, just go out and try to find a carpenter job. And if I didn't like it, then I could do the welding thing, you know. And the first day I went out, I got hired on a bridge. Hector, you got a copy?
Yeah, go ahead, Albie.
Are they off? Are they on the rollers now?
Yeah, we're on the rollers. We're setting up to just get rolled back.
I was still drinking on and off, but I didn't drink usually on the weekdays because I worked and you can't. But on the weekend, you know, I would drink, and then Monday maybe I wouldn't show up. I'd be late, you know, and that wasn't really working out, you know.
Yeah, you're even up on 1 and 2.
With this company, when I first did do that within the first 6 months, and the superintendent called me and gave me a pep talk, you know, and made me, you know, feel good about myself or whatever he did. Told me I was a good worker and everything, and that I just needed to show up every day, you know, and I could go places. And I just did after that. I just, you know, I didn't want to disappoint him. Oh, you're not talking about writing it up.
No, no, no.
Oh, I thought I was writing the basket up with the material.
No, no, no. What are your plans for the future? What are you going to do after this?